Hello, today I want to introduce you to this account and password manager that I have built using Google Sheets. So this Google Sheets template is inspired by one of my customers that has problem with tracking multiple clients' accounts data and managing different digital assets because there are so many emails, the username, the password that he has to keep track of. So here I have designed a solution based on the problem statement. So first of all, we have two tabs in this tracker. The first one is the database. Basically, here is where we record all the information for all of our clients. And then for the account dashboard, which we will come to this later, this is where we can easily find the information for our client based on their name and also the account type. So first of all, we're going to set this up first. As you can see, at the left-hand side, we have the account types. So here is where you can customize the account types that you have. Let's start filling in the data first. So for the number one, I'm going to key in just a random name. And then for the account types here, I'll just click on the drop down, and from here, we can just select the account types. For example, it's Instagram. Then I'll just key in the link for the Instagram. And here, if you want it to stick to the original color, you can just change the color. Otherwise, you can leave it as blue. Then we can start typing in the email address and followed by the username, the password, and then the information for this account is none, so we can just leave it as blank. And for the security question, if you have any, for example, you help the client to set up the account, so maybe you have done this question that you want to take note of as well. So here, maybe what color do you like? And then you can answer maybe blue. And then here you can make some note if there's any special information that you have to take note regarding this account. And then we can just go in and type in more information. So I'm going to just fill this up very quickly. So here I have just filled in some examples for social media accounts, and here I have added one more example for like a software subscription kind of account. And then here we can take note of the payment information. For example, I just key in a random number, and then we can also take note of the subscription starts on maybe 1st of April. And then for the note, we can also fill in some notes. For example, renewal on 31st April 2023, something like this. And for the security question, we can just stick to the same. So here is how you can record your client's information. So here you can see that we can accommodate for multiple clients with multiple accounts. So for example, if you have additional accounts that's not in the account types here, you can just simply type in. For example, we can have maybe Spotify. So I'll just key in that. And then here, I can just select, you can see that now the Spotify has been added into this account type. So just select that, and then we can just go on to fill in the information, something like this. Once we have set up the database, we can move on to this account dashboard. Here you can see that I have this drop down here for client name and account type. So here We can select the name of the client. For example, I select the Danalyser, and the account type, I can simply select maybe Instagram. And here you can see that I can see the email, the username, the password. And here is the password is auto hidden. So here is a small feature that I added just because of sometimes we might want to work in a cafe and all this information are quite sensitive. So you want to be careful with that. So what I did is that I have this feature. So then you can only show the password when you tick on this. And then you can hide it back with the untick. And moving on, we have other information here that we can access. So for example, I just chosen Canva. So you can see all the payment information and note has been populated here. So whenever you look at this dashboard, you know when you're going to pay for this subscription and when do you start to subscribe to this service and so on. And do take note that all these are not editable because there is a formula behind all these things. And what you can edit is just selecting the drop down and also tick this show password. That's all. So I hope this mini tutorial is useful for you to get started in using this Google Sheets and be more organized with your business. Before I end this video, thank you so much for joining me in the tour today. If you want to get more templates like this to help organize your business, you can feel free to go to theanalyzer.com and see other templates that I have in store. So I'll see you next time. Bye bye.